So we'll find him. Again, he's looking for a big one. This time comes around. Who's that? It looks like Nicholas Curtin. And Amblin coming back as the big man. And Ashley Nurse. And I can tell you, 249 for seven. Karen Pollard is not going to give him any room or any pace where he can be able to heave this one out. And he's going to tuck him up as much as possible. Nurse goes up to four. Walcott on the non-strikers, and he's three. And Pollard turns from the Sir Andrew Roberts end. He comes in now to bowl to Nurse. Nurse gets a slow ball and heads that around. Down to the boundary for four. Poor delivery by Pollard. Kicks himself, and he knows that you can't bowl us out and deliver it to Nurse. He sort of tried to bowl him a slow bumper, but Nurse waited on it. 250 up for the Barbados Pride. Score looks a little bit more respectable now. 253 for seven, and four more legal deliveries expected to be in this over. So let's see what's on the target. Let's see what fireworks Nurse can come up with. He's finally got a boundary, and let's see if he can be able to get a maximum here. Pollard working on the ball. Comes in from the Sir Andrew Roberts end, dropping in to bowl to Ashley Nurse, into bowl to Nurse. Nurse is having a go, hits his one up into the air. Pollard is going to come up with another screamer, and Nurse goes back into the pavilion. In fact, it is. So Nurse didn't get any pace onto it, and Pollard easily has picked up four wickets just like that.
Yes, sir. Picked up four easy wickets by using his head there. You know, that's some good bowling there from Kyron Pollard, and also a good catch there from Nicholas Pooran running in from the long on region. And the ball before that where Ashley Nurse got four runs, that was a good shot. That particular delivery was the sort of delivery that Ashley Nurse was really looking for. Short, slow, down the leg side, because he was looking for that, and he dealt with it perfectly, getting four runs. But the delivery after that, he could not, you know, negotiate, and he fell, and another wicket to Kyron Pollard. So, the wickets continue to tumble here at the Sir Vivian Richards Stadium. And for some strange reason, Barbados just can't get a rhythm. They can't get any sort of momentum going. And this final 10 overs has been more or less a little disappointment for them, because they were expecting to be able to get some fireworks. I thought Jonathan Carter got out at a very, very, very crucial time. 4 for 209. He should have still been there, but he's not. Walcott waits for Pollard. Defensive delivery can't score. You have to be able to get a single. You can't defend now, Walcott. You've got to be thinking about how you might going to get a single. Have to get a single.
Or even if, you know, probably
everybody's back out. Everybody's back on the 30-yard circle.
You have to do something.
Have
you
to get a single.
Back to the bowler.
Joshua Bishop, in the meantime, is coming. He's on the non-strikers end. There are two legal deliveries. Walcott has to get not only bat and ball, but he has to get a single. He's going for a hike, and Pollard looks like he's going to get five wickets. Look how easy that is. Rampall takes a catch. I can't believe this. I really can't believe this.
Good ball in there from Kyron Pollard.
Walcott just decided to have a swing at the delivery. Didn't even look at the ball. Just swung to the fences. And Rav Rampall took a tumbling catch coming in from Charles Tillman. Barbados at 253 for 9 and could be bowled out if we don't look sharp.
Yes, correct, because there's one more ball remaining, and it's a final wicket, and easy 5 for Kyron Pollard. He must be smiling and saying, I should have brought myself on a long time ago.
5 for 17 in 2.5 overs, no maidens, and they've just gifted Kyron Pollard their wicket.
So you're saying they gifted Kyron Pollard 5 wickets?
Easy, just like that. 253 for 9.
Very, very poor batting from Barbados.
The final delivery, I think it will be Joshua Bishop who will be facing Shema Holder.
This is not a way to.
We still maybe try to wonder what happened against the Hurricane.
Three overs.
When Abe Walsh took a liking to him.
5 wickets.
Today is a different day. He might decide that he wants to prove something to the West Indies wonder captain. Joshua Bishop waits for Pollard. He comes down the ball to him. And he's fishing at one. He missed it completely also. So he didn't even get back on the ball. So 50 overs have been completed. Barbados finally ends on 253 for 9. Pollard ends with the excellent figures of 3 overs, no maidens, 70 runs, 5 wickets. Let me just give you a recap, Anthony, so you can have an idea in terms of what really happened today. Earlier, Kyron Pollard won the toss and decided that he was going to field, in which he did. The Barbados Pride, they started off in what we would say a very nervous period of time. Zachary McCaskey, he was LBW to Akil Hussain for 16. He faced 33 balls, 2 boundaries. Then, Justin Graves really buckled his way to a patient 62. His 50, Justin Graves 69 balls, 81 minutes, 5 balls. In the end, he was caught rammed in, ball wrapped one ball for 62. 81 balls, 6 balls, and 1-6. Something I'm sure that he really wouldn't want to see again. He batted for some 93 minutes. Shamar Brooks didn't look himself today at all. He was run out by a Kedron Ockley and Ramden combination for 26 balls, 1 boundary. Jonathan Carter, he did all the work again before he was finally out caught. Kedron Ockley bowled Akil Hussain for 56. 70 balls, 3 boundaries, 1-6. And Ruston Chase, when he started to move, really didn't get to propel and to get into the over final over gear in the last 10 overs. He was caught for a ball Pollard for 56, 57 balls, 5 balls, 1-6. And Jason Holder, brief stay at the crease. He was caught under Sir Philip, ball Pollard for 18, 20 balls, 2 boundaries. Ashley Nurse, he was caught for a ball Pollard for 8, 7 balls face, 1 boundary. Dominic Drakes,